Meanwhile, in neighbouring Syria, the strengthening of Al-Qaeda-linked groups has led to growing infighting between once allied rebels. Fierce clashes between rival opposition factions have killed at least 700 people this week. Almost 100 of them are believed to be civilians who were executed by militants from the Islamic State of Iraq and Levant. Now, the outbreak of a civil war within a civil war has prompted some Western politicians who previously rooted solely for Assad's removal to change their stance. Now, here are just some of the latest statements we've heard. The former CIA director, Michael Hayden, said the Assad regime is beginning to look like the lesser of all evils. And the former US ambassador to Syria, Iraq and Afghanistan, Ryan Crocker, he's agreed that Assad is not as bad as the jihadis. And Russia has long been warning of the threat some opposition groups in Syria pose, with Foreign Minister Lavrov welcoming the realization of this in the West. Well, infighting within the ranks of the Syrian rebels is threatening the Russia-US brokered peace conference that's due in less than 2 weeks from now. The world's top diplomats are in Paris to pressure Syria's main opposition group, the Syrian National Council, into taking part. Well, let's discuss what might come out of it with Michel Chussodovsky. He's director of the Center for Research on Globalization. He's live in Berlin. Michel, so these Western leaders there, they're all undertaking a last-ditch effort to persuade the Syrian National Council to take part in these forthcoming talks in Geneva. Will they succeed?
I think the fundamental issue is to address the nature of the conflict. The Syrian National Council is virtually a defunct organization. They've been meeting in Spain, in Cordoba, Spain, with other opposition groups. But in effect, we have to ask the question, is this a civil war between opposing factions within Syrian society, or is it, in fact, a war of aggression? And I think at the moment, what is striking is the fact that there's a merger of the insurgency in Iraq and Syria. It's the same Al-Qaeda-affiliated organizations, Al-Qaeda and the Islamic in Iraq and the Levant, which are waging war, I say waging war against both countries. And then the question is, who is behind them? And we know that these are intelligence operations. We know that Saudi Arabia is supporting those rebels. And we know also that the United States now is supporting the new Islamic Front, which was created back in November, which is considered to be some kind of moderate grouping of Islamic organizations. But in effect, there's ample evidence to the fact that the Western military alliance is supporting the various Islamic rebel forces.
And yet the Western leaders are now becoming very aware of the consequences of what's happening, aren't they? It's interesting to hear that many are suspecting now that Assad might be the lesser of all evils, as we just heard a little earlier. And yet today's Friends of Syria meeting, that was a very different word, a message coming from the French foreign minister during that meeting. He said the following. Let's have a listen to what he had to say. Il n'y a pas
d'un côté. Contrary to what has been stated, we don't have the Assad regime on one side and terrorists on the other. It is the regime that is fueling terrorism.
So Assad's regime is fueling the terrorism. What do you make of that?
Well, these are cynical statements. The Western military alliance has been recruiting Mujahideen right from the outset, and it's confirmed by numerous and reliable sources, including Israeli intelligence. These jihadist forces are operatives of the Western military alliance, and it's a continuum right from the Soviet-Afghan war. For the West to say that Assad is allied with the terrorists or and so on and so forth, I think is a red herring. They are still intent upon destabilizing Syria as a nation state. And in fact, one has the impression now that with the situation in Iraq and Syria, that in fact what they want to do is to redraw the map of the Middle East.
Yeah, but everything you're, but surely everything you're saying is being contradicted by the fact that the West are holding a peace conference in Geneva. It wants peace in Syria.
Yes, but those, you know, that peace conference to be held, scheduled for next week in Montreux, it really is an exercise in shadow fake diplomacy, because ultimately decisions will not be taken there. They'll be taken behind closed doors between, you know, between John Kerry, Sergei Lavrov. But very important, Sergei Lavrov made the statement back in November, I believe, that the Geneva Peace II talks should focus on counter-terrorism. Now, that raises an issue, because they'll be sitting at the table together, and then the question is, who is behind the terrorists? There'll be a number of countries, there are 30 countries there. I suspect that Saudi Arabia might be present at those meetings in Montreux. But then who are the sponsors of these terrorists? Who is feeding them the weapons? And we have ample evidence. I mean, just a few months ago, Senator John McCain had a photo op shaking hands with leaders of the terrorist organizations inside Syria. So there we must understand that the Western military alliance also has blood on their hands. It's not simply an issue of identifying terrorists. We have to identify the people who are behind these terrorists.
All right, let me just ask you quickly then, with these interesting signals coming from Western leaders and Western spokespeople, what do you make of Assad's future now? Many are saying he does have a lot of support within Syria. Could he actually ride this out?
Well, I think that Assad has support within Syria, because the Syrian people realize that this is a war of aggression with mercenaries coming in, and these mercenaries are coordinated by special forces. They understand that. When you see the situation in the massacre that took place recently in Adra, well, the civilian population understood that who came to the rescue was the Syrian armed forces against these terrorists. I think it's shocking to say the least that the massacres in Adra were not covered. They were covered in some media, including the Russian media, but they were not covered by the Western media.
Well, of course, there's a lot of speculation, indeed, about the verification of that particular report, and that's obviously ongoing. So, but in the meantime, we'll have to leave it there. Michel Chussodovsky, Director for the Center for Research on Globalization, live in Berlin. Thanks for your thoughts.